it's your turn. Just keep it going.
I don't be. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum maybe is what not to do.
Snuff Nuff 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody want to get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. If you don't take me seriously,
I'm gonna go.
man in the hot pepper. See, they say that Angel Snuff Nub 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Nub 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth. And I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
We are in a state of emergency.
Prejudice. Want a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Rising up and sing back our time is here. We're taking back what's been lost for years.
Let the heaven of a system embrace you.
All these lies and all this propaganda that you want us to sing. We're gonna sing out.
It's me. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us.
We are in a state of emergency.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Keep it real.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
brother Angel Snubnub 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listened to all of Angel Snubnub 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with or which he may think differently from, and I really respect him for that. He's challenged KMBS, and he has also challenged the Black Supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
I wanna talk to
you. I know who the enemy is.
I wanna talk.
You wasting your time making mockery of me. Oh, I'm crazy. My brain is damaged. My endo poster. I'm miserable in my life. All this nonsense that you talk about. And you a slave, just like me, in a racist nation.
I believe that.
And that is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
Just keep it going.
He's forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like Dr. King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire at Reality Temple. Reality Temple. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like Dr. King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire.
I'm a bad man.
that the Nation of Islam should evolve into what we call the reality's temple on earth. You don't need no Arab hand-me-down religion. You don't even need God. You don't need these things. That's good for us in our infancy, in our immaturity, when we was babies. But as we grow and mature, and even in religion itself, it says that we are the children of God. Children can't stay children forever. Children must become adults. So if we are the children of God, that means we become God. Act like God, move like God, and have the responsibility of a God. Manifest. Welcome to the Reality's Temple on Earth, Dragon Manifest.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for having me, brother. This is an honor. When I first saw your channel, I said, oh, this is an ancestor that has most definitely returned. Yes, most definitely. This is not a new ancestor. This is an old ancestor. you could hear, you could feel the ancestors through you. You know, most people probably say, what is he talking about?
Right.
They don't get it. You gotta be on that level.
If you say that I'm divine and I'm a prophet, where the hell did your ass go to? Why aren't you heeding the call? Since I'm a prophet, since I'm divine. Some people, excuse the language, some people just like talking out their ass. 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 That's what they like to do.
Peace, love, and all. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody.
This video is for the Reality Temple on Earth.
Shout out to the Reality Temple on Earth on IG.
We love watching it.
Yeah, we really do.
We send love, peace, and soul.
Good evening, soul brothers and sisters. This is Tangie Cox, the Black Sheep. And I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is gonna hurt soul sisters and brothers, because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. The Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
are in a process of healing. It's time for change.
Ride, let's get this party started. Ride, let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, let's get this party started. Ride, let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started quickly.
It's so good to see you. Thanks for dropping in. When you get a chance, look up Soul Liberation Day, December 7th. Oh, that's right around the corner. The transformation. Bless up. Bless up. Thank you. Let's see. This came to my plurality on Earth Internet Ministry after purge. Out you. All the best to you guys. Stretch in pursuing what is possible and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Well, it's Saturday. This is our day. If you don't know by now, this, of course, is the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the gatekeeper, the host of this program, known here on social media as the Mighty One, Angel Snubnub 7. This is our day, Saturday. I started to wait till Sunday, but Sunday is not really our day. Saturday is our day. And we're going to talk on Saturday. I want to welcome those old and new to this broadcast. I hope that I don't offend anyone, but it's very difficult to speak what we speak here and people don't find offense. Thank you very much, Deacon. I don't know what to say. Because when you're telling the truth, when you speak the obvious, it doesn't make any difference how you bring it. People just aren't going to, they're not going to like hearing what does not make them feel good. So I don't know what to say. The only thing that I can do is bring you a message. Whether you listen, whether you embrace that message, that's up to you. It's according to what your maturity level is. It's unrealistic, and you should question people that always want to make you feel good. They don't have nothing bad to say about you. If they do say something negative about you or whatever, they know how to clean it up so they'll stay on your good side. Because most times they want your money. Because most times they want something from you. I don't want anything from you. So since I don't want anything from you, then I have to tell it like it is, because I'm not here to deceive you. I'm not here to trick you. I want you to be the best person that you can be as an individual. I want us to be the best people that we can be. And sometimes we have to take an ass whooping, like a lot of fathers will say. They don't really want to physically hurt their children, but they say, this is for your own good. Actually, some people have told me that. The reason why they slander my name, the reason why they want to push me around or whatever, that's for my own good. That's what they say. Sometimes your feelings have to be hurt. I notice on this channel, by the way, I just want to rant today. I just want to rant. Woo! You know when I do that, there's something that grinds my gears. I just want to rant. I uploaded an excerpt from a earlier live stream to this channel. I was talking about Malcolm X. Malcolm X going to the United Nations. And when I uploaded that video, I guess there were 4, 5, 6 people. They listened or did not like the title or whatever. They unsubscribed from our channel. I made them upset. How am I making you upset? It's probably because in the video, and you heard me say this, there are those who believe that for some reason, if Malcolm X was given the chance to go to the United Nations, we would be in much better shape and blah, blah, blah. We love miracles. We love miraculous things. We love doing no work ourselves. Leave it all to Malcolm X. Okay, well, as you know, Brother Malcolm could not do that. So what's stopping you? If that's what you believe in, what's stopping you? What have stopped you from going to the United Nations? That's what I said in the commentary. I said in the commentary that charges have been brought to the, what's they call it? The criminal court in The Hague or whatever, against Vladimir Putin for war crimes in Ukraine. Why can't you do that against the United States? Why can't you file? Matter of fact, I went on the internet. And if that's what you want to do, you can file a grievance. With the United Nations, you can go on the internet, you can file a grievance in The Hague against anybody who you believe commit crimes against humanity. And there's no doubt that what we have went through, so brothers and sisters, the black man and woman in America, there's no doubt our 400-year sojourn in this country, and it has not stopped. It should be described as a crime against humanity. It should be described as genocide. So how the hell are you going to get angry at me simply because I'm asking you, why haven't you done it? What's wrong with your brain? What's wrong with your hands? What's wrong with your feet? Oh, Malcolm's supposed to do it. So since Malcolm couldn't do it, you sit your happy ass down. If going to the United Nations is such a great idea, why didn't you do it 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago? Your lazy ass. So I'm glad those type of people are gone. Praising a dead man. If you want to really praise, if you want to honor Malcolm X, then do his work. You say that he wanted to go to the United Nations. Why haven't you been yet? I'm going to unsubscribe from you because you don't want to hear the truth. Your lazy ass. That's what the whole problem with us is. We don't want to work. We want to give the work to God or alien spaceships, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Malcolm, Medgar Evers, Sojourner Truth, Harriet Tubman, anybody but me. You want to sit on your ass and don't do nothing. Angel Snubnub 7 to do it. Oh, you got Angel Snubnub 7 wrong. I say, now, in the very beginning, I had that attitude. I want to save my people. I want to do this for my people. Maybe 10 years ago or whatever, I had the same attitude. But now, giving it some thought, why do I want to save? Why do I want to put my life on the line for some people who don't even give a damn about themselves? Some of us have drug addict friends. We have drug addict relatives. We have drug addicts. We have people that don't want to do nothing for themselves in our family. And you want to reach out and you want to help them. Some people you cannot help. And you waste your resources. You could have gave your time and your effort to your children or to the neighbor across the street instead of wasting your time with some people who don't give a damn about themselves. I'm not a savior. If I see a single mother struggling with children, I'm going to help her. and she's not bullcrapping around. She's trying to go to school. She's trying to do something. I would help somebody like that. I'm not going to help a single mother who's happy to be on welfare, ain't doing nothing in her life, got men going in and out of her apartment, smoking weed, getting drunk. No, I'm not going to help nobody like that. I'm not going to, you shouldn't have to beg nobody to want to do better. We have to come to black people in this country and I got to beg them so they can do better. You shouldn't have to beg nobody. My position, let them die. Let them keep doing what they do. I don't beg people to listen to Angel Snuff Nuff 7. You do or you don't. I could care less. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing the loser ass stuff y'all been doing for the last 100 years. Keep doing it. Don't bother me none. I want to reach out to those who are worthy. I want to reach out to those who want to do better. They don't want to do better. You want to pretend to do better. You're faking, you're a fraud. Because to do better means change. And you don't want to change. To do better means work. And you don't want to work. You want to hope that Malcolm X can come from the dead, or Elijah Muhammad, Martin Luther King, or maybe you want old Jesse Jackson. Come on, Jesse, help us. Al Sharpton. Who's the latest guy? Ben Crump. Ben Crump will help us. Always looking for a savior. I'm not your savior. I'm not a messiah. I'm not a savior, a messiah. None of that. I care about you. If you don't give a damn about yourself, I'm not going to. No, go ahead. I'm the kind of person. You want to jump off the roof? That's what you want to do? Well, zip, boop. That's the kind of person I am. I'm not going to babyfy these people. I'm not doing that. About 10 years ago or whatever, maybe it would have been different. You shouldn't have to beg nobody to want to for them to help themselves. I'm not doing it. With your lazy ass. I'm glad you unsubscribe, weak ass people. Go away. I tell people to go away all the time. You don't hurt me. It's not like they was giving me $100 a week or $100 a month. And then I was like, wow. I said something to make them mad. I'm sure gonna miss that $100 a week, $100 a month. I'm not losing nothing. You're the loser. Babyfy people. That's what you want. You want somebody to babyfy you. I'm not here to babyfy nobody. That's your damn problem. On your mama titty. Who your mama? The white man. This nation is your titty. They keep the pacifier. They don't want to put a titty in your mouth. Got you on a pacifier, drinking Similac milk. Fake ass milk, fake ass pacifier. All of you. That's why they do and act the way they do. Because they babyfied. Mama taking care of them. Still living your mom and daddy house. Keep talking that separation crap. Been over 100 years. None of y'all suckers is separating no damn where. That one brother that was here, forgot his name, Pan-African He don't call it pan universal, whatever you want to call itself. He's on Facebook. They are in Africa as a tourist. As a tourist. Being a tourist and living in a place is two different things. They're going as tourists. They're going to bring their happy ass back to Philadelphia, where they come from. There are brothers and sisters who have left this country and are living in Africa. You just went from one slave plantation to another. You don't control nothing. You're still in the same exact position, except now you got a different person that make the rules. You don't make nothing. You should be sick of it. You should not want to be, continue to be under the rule of people, whether they are African or Asian or European or whatever. You should want to be in a position. So finally, even, I don't give a, your laws don't have to be perfect. What you do have to be perfect, but it's yours. You should be sick of always bowing down to other people, serving other people, following other people. But like the deacon said, you know what your main problem is? You're not an adult. You're not grown. You're always looking for somebody to take care of your big grown ass. I got to get this off my, I got to get this off my shoulder. It's pitiful. So you get angry at me because you thought you was grown. You thought you was an adult. And in some cases, maybe you are. But you don't fit my criteria. Because my criteria is high. Some people's criteria for manhood is low. We want to talk about that real quick. This is the third year anniversary this month when I began to find out that I was carrying a form of cancer. 3 years. Soul Sister Rona Bennett had a live stream last night. And in the chat room, I was able to talk about this with her. And she asked me, how do it feel? Or I forgot exactly how she worded. But what has it been your experience with this cancer diagnosis? When you are given a cancer diagnosis, it makes the reality of life real. It makes you to know that everything has a time. And when you are diagnosed with cancer, you're running out of time, most times. You know that you cannot put off tomorrow what you can do today. That's what we talk about here all the time anyway. Don't put off tomorrow what you can do today. It makes you begin to respect life. It's like people, when you have plenty of food, you're very wasteful. I don't like the crust on the bread, so you throw the crust away. I don't like this part, and you throw it away because you have lots of food and you're wasteful because you got lots of it. A lot of young people. You think that you have a lot of time. So some young people do crazy stuff because, well, I'm 20, 21 years old. And you think you're going to live to be 80 or whatever. So I still got 50, 60 years left. That's not how it works. Nobody knows the time. There are babies, children, that die at 6 months old. There are babies that die in the mother's womb. Time is not guaranteed to nobody. There are those who make mockery of older people. There's no guarantee you're going to make it to be old. So there's a disrespect for time. There's a disrespect for life. Because you think you have all the time in the world. I got lots of it. And so every day in this country, there's funerals for young people. 10 years old, 11, 21, 25. Run out of time. Thought I had lots of time. So when you have lots of food, you have no respect for food. We have lots of water, you have no respect for water. But when you go to your sink and the water does not come out, when you go to your grocery store and the shelves are bare, there's a whole different attitude. You start thinking about all the water you wasted. And all the food you wasted. Because now you don't have it no more. And so this experience with cancer, it brings to me pure reality. And I appreciate life. Not only for myself. It's a wonderful thing to be with this audience. People that listen to this ministry. Those under the sound of my voice, because you are special. You are really out of the matrix. You have really broken the mold. You don't know how special you are. And perhaps in time, others will catch up with us one day. If time permits. But time waits for no one. The thing about the cancer, I didn't know I had it. But I could tell something was wrong. I don't know, but there was no blood in my stool. There was no diarrhea. I noticed I couldn't eat certain foods, but I don't know what was up with that. I was in no pain. I didn't know. We really didn't find out what it was until I got an MRI. An MRI is basically an X-ray, but it goes more into details of the human body than a plain X-ray. And I believe a CAT scan is even more powerful than the X-ray. Why am I saying this? Because that's us. My experience with cancer is us. You think you well. You don't know you sick. There's no blood in your urine. There's no blood in your feces. That you go about life every day with no worry. That's us as a people. I'm carrying cancer, don't even know it. Driving a truck up and down the road, don't even know I have cancer. Insides getting ate up with cancer. I don't know. That's us as a people. There's a cancer. And the thing about it is we know something is wrong. Like I did. I know something here ain't right. But I feel good. I feel great or whatever. But something is wrong. That's us. And so many people will just ignore. Well, you know, they just ignore. Because I feel good enough. You know, no big deal. And that's us. With the cancer. The first problem is, or what we should recognize, how childish we are. Here I am dealing with people, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. I'm dealing with people with a childish mentality. Sick, they don't know they sick. They don't think nothing wrong with them. It took an MRI to discover my cancer. A close examination. These people are afraid because they are in denial. Because they are in denial, to take a close examination. Because regardless if you are Christian or Muslim or Pan-African, whatever, we as a people in this country, we are sick as hell. There's no doubt about it. There's a cancer here eating you up. And you talking and walking like you don't have a care in the world. And cancer will eventually kill you without some kind of treatment, whether it's chemotherapy, whether it's holistic, whatever it is on your choice. I myself chose not to do a damn thing. 3 years doing nothing. But I understand what I'm dealing with. You walking around here with cancer and you sick. I mean, just really look at the YouTube videos that we make. I mean, really look at them. The people, how you talking. That's normal. You think that's normal behavior. You are abnormal as hell because you want to be something and that's not you. That's the problem. Trying to be somebody or something you think that you're supposed to be, and it's made you sick. There's only one Michael Jackson. And he he's gone. Anybody else is called an impersonator. I'm impersonating Michael Jackson. I'm trying to copy Michael Jackson. Anybody trying to say they are Michael Jackson are sick. We're trying to be people. We're trying to claim cultures we have nothing to do with. And we look sick. We put on these costumes and we have this narrative that we're shouting and screaming. And people around the world know that's not who we are. You're born in America. We look sick in the eyes of the world. And you think that you're intelligent. Again, it goes back to our immaturity in our mind. All of us was a baby at one time. We was infants at one time. Some of us have babies, infants in our houses right now. Babies don't come out the womb walking and running. It's a slow process. Babies crawl before they can walk. What else do babies do? A lot of babies like to touch stuff, grab stuff, and they put it in their mouth. Exploring, because all this is new to them. What's this? What's that? That's what babies do. Because all this is new. They want to try a little bit of this, try a little bit of that. Because it's new. They're new on the earth. They don't know these things. They want to try. And that's why a parent has to be vigilant, because that child might put something in their mouth that could kill them. We are a baby people. Crawling, not walking, crawling. Putting different things in our mouth. A little bit of Nation of Islam. A little bit of spirituality. A little bit of African spirituality. A little bit of Hebrew Israelite. A little bit of, you know where I'm going with this. We got to taste a little bit of everything. A little bit of Christianity, crawling, exploring, because we're new. And we have no parent to keep us from the poison. So we put anything in our mouth. We have no parent to watch us as we go through this evolution of maturity, trying to figure this thing called life out. And we are poison. When you become an adult, when animals become an adult, there's no more, or it's very rare, I taste a little bit of this and I taste a little bit of that. The adult has established their diet, what they have evolved into. It's established. But when you are a baby or a baby animal, everything is new. So you taste a little bit of this and you mess with that, whatever, because you don't know. And you see that in our behavior. I'm a Christian. I'm a Muslim. What the hell are you? And then you call yourself a people. How can you call yourself a people and you confused as bad hell? People know who the hell they are. You don't. That's why you a little bit. What are you? I'm a Christian. I'm a Muslim. I'm a Hebrew Israelite. I'm a Pan-African. I'm a pescatarian. I'm a vegan. You don't know what the hell's up. Because you're a baby crawling on the damn ground. And we have no parents. And usually babies that grow up like that, they're destined to die. Because they have nobody to protect them. They have no guidance. You're walking in the valley of the shadow of death. And there is evil. If you don't have a parent in the wild, you got to grow up real fast. You got to learn fast because there's a lot of predators. Why is Angel Snubbing up? Said, why do I talk the way I talk to us? And I know you don't like it. If you was in a fire and we woke up in a fire, I can't come to you and you are in a dead sleep. I can't come to you and talk about, shh, hey, wake up. Hey, wake up. No, you got to say, hey, you got to grab the person, shake. Hey, look, fire. We got to get the hell out of here. You can't be nice to nobody in an emergency situation. When you see a child chasing a ball, getting ready to run in front of a car, you can't be nice. You got to run as fast as you can and snatch that child as quick as you can. It's better that the child is shook up than get hit by the car. This is what you don't like about Angel Snubnub 7. We are in a situation that's dire. We are in a fire. We are in an earthquake. This is an emergency situation. This is a state of emergency. If you don't understand that, then you are a liar and a hypocrite to your own words, because all these Pan-Africans and pro-black folks, you say the same thing. But you want to be nice. You can't be nice. It includes you too. And you act like you can't be told nothing. Get your ass out. Here you are talking about making mockery of Dr. King. Dr. King said, I'm afraid that I have led my people into a burning building. And that's one of your favorite quotes about from Dr. King. But at the same time, you still living in the house. Dr. King has been gone since 1968. May he rest in peace. April 4th, 1968, our poor brother was assassinated, putting his life on the line, dying for people who don't give a damn about themselves. Excuse me. I'm not going to do it. But Dr. King done it. And you're still here in the burning house with your Pan-African ass, your Nation of Islam ass, your Hebrew Israelite, Moore Science Temple, all of you suckers, you're still here in the burning house and you have the nerve to try to make mockery and degrade and talk about the civil rights workers. You right here in the house. And of course, they don't want to talk about a lot of these pro-blackity-black, They getting drunk. They smoking weed. There's nothing more about them. That's probably why they so damn hostile. Because they smoke weed. They get drunk. They whoremongers. A lot of these old pro-black guys not paying their child support. A lot of these pro-black women sleeping with every man that she can that come on her YouTube page. That's what you got here. You're some sick-ass people. And you want to come out here and put on this front like you got it going on, and you don't. I don't like Snub 7 because I know who you are. You don't fool me. Matter of fact, you only fool yourself. Why do you think the mass of the people is 40 million plus in this country? These videos should get millions of views, but they don't. 10,000, 45,000, 50,000, y'all happy about that. It's 40 million of us in this country. They're not interested in what you're talking about because they know that you're not real. You're just another Negro in the United States, bat hell crazy like the rest of them. Bat hell crazy people. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Bat Negro. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Bat Negro. Crazy as Bessie Bug. Babies crawling, confused, have no parent. And then when you talk about your parents, you talk about dead people. Brother Malcolm, Elijah Muhammad, Dr. King, Marcus Garvey, they all dead. If they was alive, you wouldn't give a damn about them people. Dead men tell no tale. Dead men, you can take them and make them any kind of way. That's why you don't like Angel Snubbed Up 7, because I'm alive and kicking for the time being. If you said something that I don't agree with, I can tell you real quick. Dr. King can't respond to y'all crazy stuff. Marcus Garvey can't tell you nothing. Harriet Tubman can't tell you nothing. Worshiping dead folks. Because they can't say nothing about the nut stuff that y'all be talking about. We know that you're childish because of the name calling. Most of you are not qualified to debate nobody. Keep your damn mouth shut. Then when you get shut down, oh, you are Uncle Tom. You're Uncle Ruckus. You're a doo-doo head. Like children do. You're a doo-doo head. Because you can't explain your garbage. That's your problem. Because you heard Minister Farrakhan talk. You heard Marcus Garvey talk or whoever. Y'all love to listen to all these smart, intelligent people. It gets you hyped up. Then you come on social media, Kevin Samuels or whoever, Tommy Sotomayor. Then you want to come and try to repeat what they talking about and somebody tear your ass up. You a doo-doo head. You a doo-doo head. You don't qualify and don't know how to debate nobody. You don't know how to talk to nobody. Say your opinion. Go about your business. You don't know how to debate nobody. The only thing you know how to do is regurgitate parrot information that you heard. And if they don't show you or you don't understand where they're coming from, you don't know how to explain it. And the people like Farrakhan or Kevin Samuels or Tommy Smart, they're not going to come here. They're not going to mess with nobody like me. Because as soon as they hear me, they automatically know ain't nothing coming. What I really love about the any court system You got to bring the facts. And there's a certain way that you got to bring those facts. All this high intelligence, and so-called scholarship, you don't have to put it in a courtroom, but just put it in a courtroom type atmosphere. You don't have nothing coming. So you want to argue and you want to play ring around of roses and distraction tech? No. Answer the question. When they get stuck, they want to change the subject. You ain't changing the subject here. Answer the question. They don't know how to deal with that. Most of it is belief. And you can believe anything that you want to, but don't come out here and you think that you're going to paint your belief like it's reality. That's not reality. It's belief. Belief is not knowledge. Stop telling me, oh, we got the knowledge. You don't have no damn knowledge. That's your belief. The so-called Negro in this country, we make religion out of anything. A Coca-Cola bottle, we'll make religion out of it. Veganism is the new religion now. And we want to be smart and intelligent. Now, when it comes to the name-calling thing, I'm guilty. I did that back in the day. And really, it was Tommy Sotomayor that broke me from doing all that. Because I heard Tommy Sotomayor say, y'all ain't no different than the races. You using the same words that the races do. Uncle Tom, you know, Sambo, and nigga. That's their words. I don't care nothing about a vessel. I heard the truth coming from that man's mouth. I said, he's right. How can I argue with that? So from that point, I began to stop doing that. I can create my own words, which I did for a little while. I don't use it no more. I used to use the word definition, dark European. I used to use that a lot. I can make up my own. Why I gotta use stuff from my oppressor? You said that this is the oppressor, then you're gonna turn around and use the same language that the oppressor used on the people. Some of our ancestors, probably the last word they heard before the rope snapped their neck, before their body was set on fire, was nigga. And we love that word nigga. That's us as a people, I guess. Nigga, the nigga people. We love that word nigga. The Hebrew Israelites use it. The Nation of Islam folks use it. The Black Panther folks use it. We love the word nigga. Because that's who you are. Ain't nothing changed. You just are sophisticated, more complex, more money. Nigga. That's why you use it. Because that's who you are. A baby bottle drinking, similar like drinking, crawling on the damn floor. Nigga. A baby, a boy. And they called you boy at that time, a baby. You're attracted to that. And you justify. When you ask them, why are you still using the word? They justify. Well, you see, brother, nigger really comes from the word nega, which is a part of Egypt. You didn't learn that word from no damn Kemet. You learned that word from our oppressor right here in this country. They ain't learned that word from no damn Kemet. We know what that word means. Playing those silly, corny-ass games. No, you are. You use the word because that's who you are. Nothing has changed. So I'm guilty too. But the difference between you and me is that when I hear the truth, then I will acknowledge it. And I'm going to have to change my ways. You don't. You're going to stay doing, no matter what you hear, no matter what. That's why we don't. There's no sister to debate nobody. Because an idiot wants to be an idiot. You can't change somebody if they want to be an idiot. You cannot save nobody who don't want to be saved. And then they huff and puff. And they talk all this big bad stuff all the time. It gets old because your ass not going to bust up great. You're not going to do nothing. Every time these pro-black, black of the black, every time the police pull them over, they drop their guns on the ground, put their hands behind their back. What did I do? They're not going to do nothing. Now, if it was me and you, they'll shoot our house up with their AK-47. You can't even march in this country unless you ask the white man permission to go out in the public with your guns and march around and show off, because you ain't gonna shoot nobody. You ain't gonna do nothing to nobody. You would chase down other black people, other soul brothers and sisters, because you know that they can't do nothing. But you know these people, you attack white folks, you got a problem. You attack Mexicans or any of these other folks, they coming after your ass. You ain't gonna mess with them like that. But you can shoot Negroes, because Negroes ain't gonna do nothing. You ain't no damn better than the rest of the suckers that's on our case. You do the same damn thing. It's sickening. You ain't gonna bust a grape. All these thousands of videos on YouTube with your false intelligence, fake ass scholarship garbage. And you get angry when I show up. Somebody that has some sense show up. All these damn zombies. These minds bozo. Yeah, that's right, brother. That's right, brother. That's right. What's right? Feel good church stuff. You don't like Jesus no more. So the only thing you did was find you a new church to go to. Nation of Islam is another church. Pan-Africanism. These YouTube persons, it ain't nothing but another church to go to. That's all of it. Nothing but a new church to go to. Ain't none of them producing a damn thing. Except some hallelujahs and some amens. All of them. This Pan-African idiot gonna tell the people, I'm bringing you the information. He ain't gonna do nothing. Okay, you bringing the information to tell the people to do what? I'm listening to what he told. He's not doing nothing. They're not doing. He's not organized. He's not with another Pan-African group. They're not doing nothing. Want to come over here with the this false sense of intelligence. Want to pretend you smart. Then when your scholarship, when your intelligence is challenged, You fall apart because it's fake. I'm not the smartest person in the world. I would never tell you, and I never come on here telling people I'm so smart, I'm so intelligent. I was working in a hotel. And there was a convention of scholars of physics, astronomy, and stuff like that. I only know basic astronomy, physics. I only know some basic stuff. Maybe at the grade school level. I don't know about that. I started talking, putting my opinion about some of these things. And these older men, majority of them was white guys, and it was a couple of brothers that was there. Contrary to popular belief, soul brothers and sisters, some of us, we are into physics and astronomy and all that type of good stuff. I don't even remember what I was saying. Whatever I was saying, I got their attention, and they started crowding around me listening to what I had to say. I don't know why. I was nothing but a valet parking cars. That's all I was doing. And I have all these scholars and people. I don't even know what the hell I was talking about. They was gathering around me, and the people, my supervisors, wanted to break it up, but those people are customers. You know, they pay in the hospital, so they let me talk whatever I was talking. I stopped valeting cars. I was having a conversation with these people. I don't even know what the hell I was talking about. So whatever I was saying, it got the respect of people who actually studied physics and astronomy. I was able to get their attention and keep their attention. You don't see these type of people hanging out on these YouTube channels. If you notice, now tell me if I'm right or wrong. The people that actually have degrees in history, science, physics, astronomy, astrology, whatever you want to call it, people who actually went to school and studied, many of these people don't even have YouTube channels. And you don't see them on Sinetta TV. You don't see them messing with Tariq Machine. You don't see them messing around with the Nation of Islam making video. These people actually went to school for this. What we see is a bunch of jailhouse Negroes. They was in jail, read a few books. I'm a self-made scholar. It's amazing how people that barely graduated out of the third grade spent 20 years in prison. Now all of a sudden you're a scholar. It's amazing. If you was that interested in that type of education, why don't you take your ass? Matter of fact, it's never too late. It's never too late to go to school. It's a sister on Facebook. She's over 100 years old, just graduated out of college. So it's never too late to go to college. If you're that really interested in history and all these different things, take your happy ass to school and get a degree. Then you have people like Dr. Wesley Muhammad, who have a degree. I don't know what his degree is in, but he uses his degree to try to make religious garbage credible. He didn't go to school for that. But you want to believe him because, ooh, Dr. Wesley Muhammad, he got a degree. What do he have a degree in? They use their degree to deceive you. You could be a lawyer. All lawyers can't do the same thing. When you become a lawyer, all lawyers specialize in different parts of law. Most lawyers, Most lawyers won't even represent themselves. A lawyer will hire another lawyer because they don't specialize in many things. But this is the kind game. This is the deceit that us babies were crawling and putting stuff in our mouths for the last 100 years. Trying to find our way. And we have no parents. We have no parents to help us. So they love history. On Sinetta TV, that's all they talk about. Basically, biblical history. Bible history, Quran history is not real history. That's religious beliefs. That's not real. But there's an obsession with that because you can't make history. My role model in basketball is Michael Jordan. But if I can play just as good as Michael Jordan, I'm not an NBA, but if I can play just as good as Michael Jordan or somebody in the NBA, I'm not really impressed by them. I like Michael Jordan. I like LeBron James and rest in peace, Kobe Bryant. They really don't impress me like that for me because I've been out on the court. Everywhere I go, I be throwing down. I'm not an NBA. People have been told me, wow, man, you good enough to be in the NBA. That's not my thing. But I make my own history. I'm not in Sports Illustrated, but there are many people who have played basketball with me. They will tell you about Angel Snub Nub 7. I make my own little history. So I'm not really impressed by the points that Michael Jordan make and what Kobe Bryant can do. I'm not really interested in that. I'm not a basketball player like that anyway. I'm not impressed by them like that. But when you do nothing, so you need to live off the back of somebody else. You got to talk about Kemet or what somebody did in the Bible because you don't have nothing. You don't have no your own story to tell. And you're too damn ashamed. We talked about this on an earlier video. You're ashamed of your slave background, so you don't want to talk about that. So you want to steal other people's history. And hell, when you examine it, it's not that great either. Nobody on this planet has been perfect. Nobody on this planet can brag about this or that. Most people are foul. You're gonna find foulness in everybody. Slavery existed before the white man started doing it. You will even find examples of slavery, even in the animal kingdom. There's some ants that enslave other ants. So this is not nothing new. But we got all this history to talk about. And you're obsessed with history. Mind you, nobody have no degrees in the history. They don't even have a theology degree. You're talking all this religious stuff and nobody even have a theology degree. But you're not making no history. You talk about the history of the Israelites, the Hebrews, what Jesus did. What about you? What about your history? You're obsessed with history, the past. What about the present? Your history. I like history. I love autobiographies. We learn a lot from the past. But we're supposed to be making histories too. Get tired of talking about other folks. I don't even give a damn if we related. I don't care what my people did. What am I going to do? I want to talk about me. It don't make no difference what Dr. King did and what Malcolm X did. What about us in 2023? They made their history. And many of them are no longer here with us. We are alive here and we're not able to make history. We're not able to do anything. That's embarrassing. It's embarrassing. We have a brain. We have hands. Why we can't do what they done? Matter of fact, we are in a better position than they was in and can't accomplish nothing. And you get angry at Angel Snuff Number 7 because I'm telling the obvious. It's the obvious. There's nothing to debate. It's obvious. I had surgery on my tooth a few weeks ago. And they gave me some antibiotics and they gave me some type of oral gel to put on my jaw because my jaw kept hurting even after all that. Now, I did not take the antibiotics because I felt as though I didn't need no antibiotics. I started taking this oral gel thing, like Amber. It's something like Ambisol, but it's prescription strength, like Ambisol. They told me to use a cotton swab or something like that or whatever. And it wasn't doing anything. And my jaw was hurting. I'm like, I got to do something about this. And I had taken some Advil or whatever, some kind of painkiller. The painkiller didn't even do nothing. So I'm saying, I'm like, I don't really know. This is not working. I didn't even call the dentist. I decided to use my own mind for a change and see what I could do. So instead of the cotton swab, I used it like toothpaste and start to put the stuff on my jaw like it was toothpaste. And slowly but surely, the pain in my jaw began to stop. The way they told me to do it wasn't working. I came up with my own way and it worked. Why am I saying that? Because I took their advice from somebody who's supposed to know these things. But when it didn't work, I used my own brain. I used the chemical that they gave me, but I used it in a different way. Why we think we can't solve our own problems? We can take advice or use as a foundation what Marcus Garvey said or what the Nation of Islam done, whatever. We got to take these things and make them our own. Because it might that way, their way during that time might not work for us, and it's not working for us. We got to use our own. What's wrong with that? What worked for one may not work for another. Speaking of Advil, when you go to the drugstore, you have Bayer aspirin, you have Excedrin, you got Advil, you got Tylenol. You got all these different things because what might work for one might not work for another. What's wrong with using our own brain? Well, the teachings, that's your problem, the teaching. The teachings from 1930, 1920, 5,000 years ago. This is 2023. They got us living in the past. So you're angry at Angel Snuff Nub 7. Because I'm telling us we got to work. And you know your ass don't want to work. You don't want to do nothing. And you're angry at Angel Snuff Nub 7. Because I want our own. We respect Marcus Garvey. We respect Elijah Muhammad. We respect Brother Malcolm. We respect the people that came before us. We have to be ourselves. I don't want to be an African. I don't want to be a Native American. I don't want to be an Israelite. I don't want to be that stuff. I want to determine who and what I am. There's a problem. Something wrong with Angel Snuff Nub 7. And the reason why you that way, because you have no vision. You're not creative at all. You're not creative. You have no vision. You have no purpose. You have no goal. You have nothing. Trying to copy dead people and foreigners. And what did it do for them? What is their condition? Well, most of our people, they're dead. What did the teaching, what did all that, what is it doing for the foreigners? Islam. What did it? These foreigners had Islam and Christianity for thousands of years. What did it do for them? Well, it made them want to enslave people. That's one thing we know it did. They enslaved themselves. Then they saw, oh, black people make good slaves. And they began to enslave black. That's what Islam and Christianity done. And y'all holding on to this stuff for dear life. Why would you want to be associated with this kind of stuff? Why do you want to be associated with it? And one of the big things that the men don't like about Angel Snuff Nub 7, because my criteria, my qualifications for manhood is extremely high. And you know you can't live up to it. But you want to be called a man. I'm not going to call you nothing you did not earn. So you can take your happy ass on and roll out. You're not a full functioning man. All over YouTube, they talking about alpha male, beta male, and all this other garbage. You a beta male. Matter of fact, you probably less than that. You don't have nothing. You live in the house of a man that raped your grandmamas, lit your grandfather. You live in the house happy and smiling. And you depend on them for all the necessities of life. You spit out babies and you don't make baby milk. You don't make baby seats. You don't make no baby clothes. You don't make no tires for your car to take your baby to the hospital. You have no hospital for your baby. I'm Mr. Man. I'm an alpha male. What you are alpha of? You are alpha of the beta males, if anything. And when your children grow up, they know you don't run nothing. They know you're not an alpha male. That's why we're having all this problem with these women. Because these women know we're not no damn alpha male. Some of these women would pop a cap before y'all would. And she ain't going to jail. That's your way out, going to jail and prison. So you don't have to have no responsibility for nothing. In and out of jail. No, that's your way because you don't want no responsibility or nothing. Life is too hard for your alpha ass. Then these men on YouTube, 24 hours a day, talking about women's weaves and their makeup. Who gives a damn? What man is going to be on YouTube 24 hours a day talking about women's weaves? So I guess you're concerned about her tampons too. It's sickening. When you straighten these men up, these women will follow behind and the children will follow behind. You're not a man. You might be a man on Sonetta TV. You might be a man with Tariq Nasheed. You might be a man in the Nation of Islam, or the Hebrew Israelite, or the Moors. You're not no man and don't qualify to be no man here. When you earn it, I'll call you that. You control no resources. You don't produce the necessities of life. You're not part of no military to protect yourself. Mr. Man. And then when you do get caught up, like I said earlier, when you do get caught up, you drop your damn guns on the ground. What did I do? What did I do, Terry? What did I do? You ain't gonna bust a grape. I protect my wife and my... You ain't gonna protect nothing. You have the nerve to make mockery of the Miss Campaign. Mr. Kevin is the only thing that I've ever heard that can put us in a position where we can say that we are. Matter of fact, you don't have to say you're men. It's going to be quite obvious. You don't have to say nothing. Because only a man can accomplish the goals of the Mississippi campaign. That's why y'all can't get with the Mississippi campaign, because you're not men. All you want to do is debate senseless, non-productive topics every damn day. YouTube gurus producing nothing of substance. It's thousands of these creeps producing nothing. Not a clinic, not a hospital, a car dealership. We have to go a housing project, something so that we can put our people into some low-income housing or something. They're not producing nothing. They can't even do nothing for your dog. And whatever these suckers do, they're doing it for themselves. I'm doing this for the people. You're a damn lie. You're doing it for your funky-ass family. They ain't doing nothing for no people. I'm the people. How am I benefiting? I'm the people. They ain't doing nothing for nobody. I'm a man. Like I said, you're not no man here. You don't produce nothing. You don't protect nothing. You don't provide nothing. I'm going to call you a father. What they teaching the children? How to be spooky. The honor be Elijah. How to be a damn slave to somebody. We're getting ready to talk about that too. We're getting ready to talk about that. Teaching these children nonsense. Foolishness. Spookism. Religious. Nigga babble. I love that word. I actually like that word. Nigga babble. I actually like it. It's babble. babbling. Want to look smart, feel smart. And you only impress other nigga babblers. People on the outside looking in, them people crazy as hell. I'm the only one they bother on social media. Every time I turn around, my channel getting flagged for whatever reason. Videos from 10 years ago. What? From 10 years ago. And other Negro trash flat. What you bothering me for? I only have 10 subscribers. I only get 10 views. You know the reason why. You know the reason why. I just wanted to rant. I just wanted to rant that off. It's very sickening to me. Mr. Man, you Mr. Man, and cannot even handle somebody talking. You can't even handle me talking. They get all upset in their panties. These men, yeah, you wear panties. Got your panties all bunched up. Don't want to work, don't want to do nothing. You all praise and honor just because you got a penis. What kind of penis you got? It came from Krypton some damn where? I asked the question, when did we become a man? Because you spent at least 300 years on a slave plantation. Then 100 years we know that your ass wasn't a man getting your ass kicked in Jim Crow. When did we become men? And then look, do a Google search and look at the men. Some trying to copy, you know, with the bow tie or whatever, hup-hold, and with the red cap on their head and tassel, with the little tassel on there, and you look like a bunch of clowns. Wearing purple. Put on your army fatigues. Yeah, your busts are great. Trying to look mean. You're nothing like the brothers and sisters in the 1960s. You're nothing like them. They knew exactly how serious things were. You're not serious about nothing. You don't want to go to jail. Oh, so y'all talk all this. No, you don't want to mess around. But you don't want to get killed. You're scared of death. And you don't want to go to jail. Especially when some of y'all make mockery of people that went to jail and prison. You're scared of that. How are you going to protect anybody and you're scared to go to jail? You're scared to go to the morgue. And then some of you who aren't scared, you ready to die for some dumbass stuff, like some crack cocaine, some beer, a donut. You ready to die for dumbass stuff. See how messed up we are? Because you're sick and don't even know it. And you're scared to go under that x-ray to see how sick you really are because you think ain't nothing wrong with you. Manhood. Did I have? The main topic that we want to talk about Malcolm X goes off on his wife Sister Betty Shabazz. And this is based upon the movie Malcolm X, 1992, by Spike Lee. Those who follow Louis Farrakhan don't like the movie. I thought that the movie was very, very good. Denzel Washington did a wonderful job portraying Malcolm X. I thought that the movie was very good. And Spike Lee was really able to capture the essence of the mindset, the mentality of Muslims. Shout out to Spike Lee and all those associated with this movie. Malcolm X, shout out to the great Denzel Washington. Excellent job. I was just looking at his sister. Who was the lady? Who was the sister? Who was the sister that played Betty Shabazz I just was watching her video this morning. What's her name? She played Tina Turner too. What's her name? Put in the chat room. Help me with this here. Shout out to all those who helped finance and helped Spike Lee with this movie, because Brother Malcolm definitely deserved that type of honor. What is her name? The sister that played Betty Shabazz, and she played Tina Turner too. Also, she was in Ready to Exhale or something like that. What's this sister's name? And she just was nominated for an Oscar in Wakanda Forever. I forgot what that sister's name. Anyway, shout out to her playing sister Betty Shabazz. There we go. Angela Bassett. I knew it was Angela something. I knew it was something like Angel something. I couldn't forget. I was just watching her video this morning. Angela Bassett, exactly. Angela Bassett. Okay. Now, this is based on the movie, so I don't want people coming here talking about that didn't happen and blah, blah, blah. This is based on the movie. And the movie is supposed to be based upon, I believe, the autobiography of Malcolm X, of which I haven't yet read it yet. I need to get that book and read the autobiography of Malcolm X. We was just talking about manhood, the criteria of manhood. I'm a man. Shout out to our Facebook and Instagram people. I appreciate those supporting our Facebook and Instagram pages. There's a scene in the movie and Malcolm and Sister Betty was talking, and they got into a little heated argument. And Sister Betty, and I believe this is before the chickens come home to roost crap happened. That was their excuse to make a move on Malcolm. This was before she was trying to tell Malcolm, these people are not right. They're jealous. These ministers are jealous of you. They're envious of you. These people are not your friends. Malcolm didn't hear that. He didn't want to hear that because he was obsessed with this religious garbage. And the argument got to the point in the movie when Malcolm told Sister Betty, "Don't you raise your voice in my house." When I heard that line, it stuck with me. "Don't you raise your voice in my house." Talking to Sister Betty. Now, when you're married, ain't that our house? What do you mean, Negro? What do you mean you gonna tell me I'm your wife? What do you mean don't raise my voice in your house? See, that goes to show you right there, the Nation of Islam teaches. This is what they teach. Teaching something and doing something is two different things. The Nation of Islam teaches that we're supposed to protect the black woman and we're supposed to put the black woman on this pedestal. The reality is they don't do that. The only one who's on a pedestal is Elijah Muhammad and those close to Elijah Muhammad. That's who's on the pedestal. That's talk, even to this day. Louis Farrakhan is on the pedestal. There ain't no day on women. It's Farrakhan, the man. And during the history of the Nation of Islam, there's a bunch of adultery going on, fornication. But it's kept on the down low. But a lot of this information is coming out. I already know. I was around. I was seeing different things. I know about a brother that was 21, raped a sister. Well, it's supposed to be consensual sex. But she was 14. He's 21. That's pedophilia. He raped the girl. His own sister. He wearing a bow tie while he humping on her. All praises, woo, due to Allah. I know about this. There are those who fall in love with this picture of holy and righteous folks. It could have been that way. But they didn't want it that way. Because see, discipline, these disciplines is too hard. "Don't you raise your voice to me in my house." Sister Betty telling him. Because clearly she wasn't all obsessed. She could see the reality of things. She told Malcolm, "Look how we're living." Oh, wow. Woo, what a lesson. What a lesson. In the movie, she told Malcolm, "Look how we live." All this is Nation of Islam stuff. She know they can take it away anytime they felt like it. This is not ours. We barely own the clothes on our back. She tried to tell her husband, "I don't want to live this way because a wife, I want my own." Malcolm caught up in this cult mindset. Sister Betty looking at the reality of she's a believer. So you can be a Christian, you can be a Hebrew Israelite, you can be a Muslim Pan-African, but damn, keep it real, y'all. See things for the way they are. Sister Betty tried to tell this man, "We got children here. We don't have nothing. We got a broke down ass car, this raggedy ass house. You gone all the time." He's so blind. He's so enamored over another man, not a woman, a man. When you, if I married Terry Ellis, she should be my number one. You're sleeping with Sister Betty. You're making babies with Sister Betty. This is your family. And you're going to put your family needs over because you're going to ignore your own family needs for this old ass man because he's divine. So this shows them how sick Malcolm was. Wouldn't listen to your wife. Because she wasn't caught up in that stuff. How you gonna put an old ass man, some divine person, over my wife and my children? But that's what they do. That's a cult mindset. It's all about that leader. The hell with everybody else. Got your wife living in a broken down ass house, broken down ass car. As a man, you don't have nothing. Your bow tie came from the Nation of Islam. Your shirt, your shoes. And you trust them to take care of you. Mr. Man, no man is going to put themselves in a position to do that. Only boys and bums. Boys and bums. As a man, as a husband, and you in your right mind, you don't want to put your wife and your children in a position where you can't provide for them like that. But Malcolm and many other brothers in this country right now, they caught up like that. They will sell their wife and their children down the damn river for a penis, the divine penis. Mr. Man, that don't sound homosexual to you? So I always raise the question, you mean, if you caught up like that, if Farrakhan or Elijah Muhammad or the divine men ask you to bend over and give them some butang, you mean to tell me you're going to say no? Because apparently God told them to ask you for some mud. Now y'all know, you know we pro Malcolm here. We are pro Malcolm here. But this is the reality of it. Malcolm was caught up and cult behavior. His wife tried to warn him. He wouldn't listen. Mr. Intelligent Malcolm, Mr. Scholar, super intelligent. Some of the most dumbest ass people is the intelligent folks. And the sad thing about it is, what happened to Malcolm street smarts? You don't know game? The reality is, Malcolm was involved in criminal activity. He really wasn't a criminal like that because he should have been able to peep game. Red Fox was caught up in some stuff too, but as you know, Red Fox became Fred Sanford. He became a comedian, TV star. But he really wasn't a criminal like that. Malcolm was just trying to survive. He really wasn't a criminal like that. Malcolm X parents were Garveyites. That was still part of him. And so when the Nation of Islam came along, it fired up the Garveyite. The example of his parents was still there. And he got caught up on that slave plantation. If I'm disrespectful to Malcolm, let me know in the chat room. Caught up in cult behavior. You're going to put your wife, you're going to push your wife and your children to the side for this old ass divine man. And they treated him like garbage to the day he died, to the day they killed him. He could have got out of it, did things differently if he listened to his wife. But he didn't. And he paid for it with his life. He was given a warning. God gave him a warning through his wife. Because she could see and he was too damn blind. The great Malcolm. Mr. on TV Malcolm. Debate Harvard students and Yale students and got caught up in that foolishness. And that cult. That's cult behavior. And this is what they say to justify cult behavior. Elijah Muhammad saved my life. If it wasn't for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, I don't know where I'd be. Well, for Malcolm, we know he went to an early grave. We know this. If it wasn't for Marcus Garvey, if it wasn't for Noble Drew Ali, I heard Tahaka Bay say that about the Moorish sign. If it wasn't for the Moorish sign temple, I don't know where I'd be. It saved my life. If somebody saved your life, they did it out of compassion. They did it because of their humanity. They just wanted to save your life. You don't owe them nothing. If that's the case, all the police officers, all the firefighters and doctors and paramedics, whoever, they should have thousands of worshipers, thousands of followers. Oh man, Fireman Jack saved my life. I owe Fireman Jack. That's cult behavior. You don't owe them nothing because somebody saved your life. They're supposed to be doing it to have compassion for you, to want you to do better. You don't owe them nothing. I want to make this point and we're going to get out of here. There's an episode of the Brady Bunch. It's been a long time, I forgot exactly. So if I'm in error, I know that I'm getting it right. I don't know exactly how it went, but from what I remember, there was an episode of the Brady Bunch. And Bobby was climbing this ladder, I believe. And something went wrong and the ladder started falling back some kind of way. And his brother Peter just so happened to be there and caught him and stopped him from being hurt from falling off the ladder, something to that effect. And then Bobby was like, oh, Peter, you saved my life. Oh, I owe you. And Peter's like, you don't owe me nothing. You're my brother. I say, no, no, no. I owe you, man. And so Bobby started want to do Peter's chores and want to do everything for Peter, because if it wasn't for Peter, I wouldn't be allowed to do nothing anyway. So I want to serve Peter. Now, Peter is not like the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Peter is not like the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan and all these other quacks and charlatans and preachers and whatnot. Peter's like, I'm getting tired of this. At first, I think Peter sort of liked it. You know, all that attention that he was getting from his brother Bobby. But he's like, I don't need all this. He was getting tired of Bobby. I owe you, man. You saved my life. I owe you. He was saying that every day. You know you saved my life. So to get Bobby to stop doing that, he had to try to set up something so Bobby could save his life so they would be even. But the point that I'm trying to make is, you don't owe nobody nothing. If they trying to save your life, that's because they was looking out for your best interest. When you're dealing with religion and some of these ideologies, the reason why they want you to do better so that you can worship them, it comes with strings attached. As soon as the strings start to come unattached, the Nation of Islam didn't want nothing to do with Malcolm X no more. I thought we was brothers. We don't have to agree on everything. I thought we was brothers and sisters. See, that goes to show you right there. These people are not sincere about loving us, caring about us. They want us on their slave plantation. And that's why they don't like Angel Snuff Number 7, because I know what you are. These are religious organizations. They use our oppression as a selling tool. If you go on Facebook right now, they will tell you what the fruit of Islam is supposed to be about. It's not about liberation. It will say the fruit of Islam is about propagating Islam to the people. That's their number one. It said nothing about liberation or revolution. It's about propagating Islam. Where did you get your Islam from? These foreigners. To take you from one slave plantation to another. It is not to liberate you from anything. It is not to cause a rebellion in society. To bring you to some foreigner's punk ass god that don't exist. Save my life. What do we usually do for doctors or lawyers, paramedics, police officers? What do we normally do when they save our life? You just said, basically just said, thank you. Sometimes we give them a reward. But we don't go around worshiping folks because they saved our life. Religion is not about saving your life. Religion is about converting you and making a slave out of your ass, like Malcolm was a slave. And unfortunately, he did not live long enough maybe to totally get out of it. But he still was a slave. He went from the Nation of Islam slave plantation to the Arab slave plantation because he was hooked on that stuff. He was hooked on that religious cocaine. Cocaine! Don't you raise your voice in my house. Don't put this old man over your wife that you sleep with, that you said that you love. For this man, because he's so divine, he's special. This special penis. Ain't no way to hell. ain't no way to hell that's gonna happen on my watch, not here. That's what they do in cults. They separate you from your loved ones. It's all about that leader. It's all about that divine person. Yeah, you married to Sister Betty, but you really married to Elijah Muhammad. That sounds homosexual to me. That's gay to me. Matter of fact, I even heard a brother even talk about that some kind of way. We all married to Elijah Muhammad. We all married to Farrakhan. I'm like, not me. I don't know about y'all, not me. I ain't married to no Farrakhan. I always spoke my mind. But they kept me around because I did a lot of work. That's why they kept me around. Because I know, since I spoke up my mind like that, I was in subordination many, many times. They never talked about kicking me out of the organization. They never brought me up on no insubordination charges. They looked over a lot of the things that I said because I put in a lot of work. And it wouldn't work. They're like, man, forget that. This cat putting in all this work. That ain't nothing. We just look over that. Because I put in the work. That's why they didn't kick me out the Nation of Islam. I was putting in the work. And you don't have to tell me what to do. I'm going out there doing my thing. I don't need nobody to tell me, oh, could you go over here and do this? I'm doing my thing. I'm making meetings with the preachers in the community. I'm always out in the community shaking hands and trying, you know, public relations with the people out on the streets. Putting in that work. I was always there. Now, if I said something, if you think that I disrespect Malcolm talking the way I did today or whatever, please put in the chat room. Let me know. That's what happened. How you gonna get upset about the obvious? That's what happened. His wife, who loved him, the Nation of Islam, who didn't love him, his wife tried to warn him about those people. Oh, he caught up. Caught up in the magic, the divinity of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I've never been obsessed with nobody like that. The only person that would come close to that would be my mama. My mama. Be obsessed with nobody like that. If anybody saved my life, did anything for me, it was my mama. Yeah, you're a good talker. And they make all these promises. To this day, none of the stuff that the Nation of Islam talk about, none of it have come true. Almost 100 years. None of the stuff that the Christians say or the Moors say, none of that stuff have come true to this day after thousands of years. Can't y'all see y'all caught up in some woo bull doo doo? We're gonna have to be nice. We should be sick of it. That Pan-African stuff ain't going nowhere. That Aboriginal stuff ain't going nowhere because y'all all got the same crazy ass mindset. It's not going nowhere. Like the deacon said, come and get your MRI. You need to look at yourself a close examination and determine that you got cancer. Now that you know that you got cancer, how do we treat it? I'm telling you, the beginning of that treatment is the principles the vision and the purpose and the goal of what we call the Mississippi Campaign. That's the beginning of that treatment. We will begin to eradicate all these things. Having a cult mindset just make things worse for us. You don't need those things. We don't need that in our life. Time, not Angel Snuffed Up Seven. Time has shown us that's not the way to go. Time has told us, is telling us, begin to use your own brain. I'm on Facebook, I'm on social media, and the only thing I'm talking to is copies, parents, regurgitation. I don't even know who I'm talking to. Clones, sycophants, symbionts of these divine suckers, blood suckers of the poor. So there's a lesson here in the life of Malcolm. And if I wanted to be like Elisha Muhammad, if I wanted to be like some of these people, I wouldn't even be talking like this. Because I want followers. I want somebody to follow me. Matter of fact, I wouldn't be talking like this at all. Because talking the way I do don't get you no money. It don't get you the panties. I gotta talk. In order for me, I know what I need to say in order to get the money in the panties. Just make you feel good. Keep telling you how wonderful you are and beautiful you are. Everything is all hunky dory. These folks will eat that up. And argue back and forth about the Bible and the Quran and stuff like that. You eat that up. These folks actually do like Angel Snuffed Up Seven. They don't like the Reality's Temple. They don't. They like Angel Snuffed. They wish they had my voice speaking for them in a church. In the Moore Science Temple, or in the Nation of Islam, they wouldn't mind my voice being in their house, speaking for them, a Pan-African. They don't want to deal with reality because their children still sucking their thumb, still crawling on the floor, filled with cancer, confused, don't know what the hell you are. I'm a people. What people? You don't know what the hell you are. How you gonna be a people and everybody saying, I'm a this, I'm that, I'm this, that. No people do that. Whatever the definition of American is, that's what they are. There is no this and I'm a little bit of that. If we are people. Unless you confuse the hell. One thing for sure, what you are, and you can call yourself anything that you want to, you and I are American citizens, whether you like it or not. And you will be treated as American citizen. That's the reality of it. So you can be whatever you want to at home. But when you cross the border of the United States, you are an American citizen. Crazy ass. You're crazy as a Bessie bug, but you're an American citizen. You want to tell us what you are? This nation already done told you. You was born here. You are an American citizen, and that's how you're going to be treated. All this other stuff don't mean nothing in the eyes of the world. You get caught up in a crime in another country, they're going to say these Americans was here. What, just a few weeks ago, about a month ago, those brothers and sisters went down to Mexico for a plastic surgery or whatever it was? Those Americans. Those Americans. They didn't call them no Hebrew Israelites. They didn't call them no Pan-Africans. They didn't call them none of this stuff that we're talking about. They called them Americans. Live in a reality. That's your own, all this other stuff is your own personal religious crap, which is protected by the Constitution in this country. Religious garbage. You can keep living in La La Land if you want to, make you feel good. It's another church. So again, I'm not a Messiah. I'm not a savior. You do whatever the hell you want to do. If you want to be successful, I'm the man. We're the man. We're the people with the solution. We are the real warners. Like Sister Betty tried to warn Malcolm. His ass did not listen. Then he got caught up. And he paid for it with his life. And you're going to pay for it with your life. This is not a threat. This is not a prophecy. This is not a fear tactic. This is the reality of things. Your fate is going to be the same like Malcolm. Because you wouldn't listen. You caught up in a cult. Countless different kinds of cults. Giving your life to the divine something, the divine God, an angel, man or woman, whatever, the divine. And that's cool. What do the divine do for you? Give your broken down ragged ass house, a ragged ass car, and work your ass to death. That's what the divine do for you. That's what they did for Malcolm. Ragged ass house, car, and work the hell out of him. Couldn't even be with his family because you're working for the divine cause. And they divinely put you in the grave. So there's a lesson here to be learned. Are you going to heed the call? Sister Betty was a warner. We are warners. Giving your money away. Millions of dollars to these parasites every year. And you have the nerve to talk about the Christian church. And you do the same thing. The pastor don't give them nothing. And all this pro-black Pan-African stuff don't give you nothing either. I don't even think Sonnetta TV, I don't even think he give turkeys away no more. I remember, I think it was one time, I thought that Sonnetta gave turkeys away for Christmas. I seen it one time. Nation of Islam don't even do it no more. I remember when we gave away turkeys during Thanksgiving and Christmas and stuff. They don't do nothing for us no more. Nothing. Malcolm went to his grave. He had nothing. Oh, but you got the hype. Oh, Malcolm was so smart. Malcolm the scholar. He was brilliant. He really. Not according to the MRI. A close examination. Malcolm was a fool. Got caught up in a cult. And by the time he realized it was too late. Because they had determined that he needed to die. So are we going to follow in those footsteps? Or are we going to do something different? Except reality, my friend, is much easier. again. You know we are pro Malcolm X here. And Malcolm deserved honor and respect. But nobody's perfect. Malcolm messed up in this case. Those people never had his interest at heart. Only what you can do for the honor of Elijah Muhammad. Only what you can do for the leaders of these organizations. They don't care about no women. Oh, let's protect the women. They don't protect no damn women. They don't do nothing. It's all about the leadership. I've been watching some of these Muslims. They eating so damn. I thought they supposed to eat 1 meal a day. Jaws all fat. Suits all big. Minister Farrakhan's son. I remember when Minister Farrakhan's son was. You know, he was built, you know, in shape looking guy. Now he look all fat and wobbly. They even, y'all got him eating good, probably eating kosher lobsters. Kosher lobsters and whatever. Lamb chops. They eating good. Everybody on the stand look fat. Farrakhan look fat, jaws all fat, falling down. His wife looked fat. Everybody on the stand look all fat. They eat no 1 meal a day. They put on this show, I can guarantee most of those FOI cannot even do 2 push-ups. They put on this show, hup, 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 yeah. It's a show. Like they do in church. Put on the music. Dun, 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 dun. Put people hop. It's a show. It's all a show. Pan-Africans do the same thing. All of them do the same thing. They put on that costume and whatever and put on a show. And we know that it's a show because it don't produce nothing. You still want to keep doing that. How you gonna get angry at me when you say Malcolm? If Malcolm went to the United Nations, things would be much, much better. What's stopping you? What's stopping you from going to the United Nations right now? Lazy ass. See, that's the thing about Malcolm. We put things in other people's hands. Angel's gonna do this. You know, Malcolm gonna do it. Farrakhan do that. We don't want to take no responsibility or hold ourselves accountable for nothing. God gonna do this. But even God, even Allah said that you gotta do something for yourself first. I will help you, but you gotta show me that you're worthy of my help. And that's what I said. I don't mind helping our people, but the people gotta show that they're worthy of help. I'm not coming out, I'm not gonna sacrifice my life and things and help these suckers that don't give a damn about themselves. I'm not doing it. I don't owe nobody nothing. I'm not responsible for grown people. So-called adults. Mr. Man. Mr. Mrs. Woman. I'm not responsible for grown-ass people. I'm only responsible for myself and my children and my wife. I have no wife. I have no children. I'm only responsible. I don't owe nobody nothing. Anything else I decide to do is because of my compassion and my love for humanity itself. And you don't owe me nothing. There's no strings attached. You don't have to listen to the Reality Temple on Earth. You don't have to do nothing I say. But with these religions, when they give you a crumb of bread, Jesus giving you the crumb of bread. When you get something from the Nation of Islam, they letting you know this religious garbage has something to do with that. It's not coming from their heart. It's coming from Allah. They want to let you know because they want to sell you. these beliefs so you can become a new cult member. And most people, just like Malcolm, a lot of people get caught up because they were in bad situations. Malcolm was in prison. People going through bad times, poverty, oppression. That's when these religions come in to get their victim. They saved my life. How is your life being saved when you become a slave? You ready to serve? You hear them in church. I'm here to serve God. I'm here to serve Allah. In other words, I'm a slave. You're a slave. So how was your life saved? To become a slave. And it's all about them. And everything about you is gone. Not here. It's not going to happen here. It's not going to happen. You owe me nothing. There's no strings attached. You don't have to serve nobody except yourself. Take care of yourself. Don't send me no $10 and you need that $10 for your cable bill or milk for your children. Don't do that. Serve yourself. So on that note, we're going to get out of here. I appreciate it. I just wanted to get that off my back. Things that grind my gears. I just want to let off some steam. I want to tell you that I appreciate all of you out here. I want to tell you that you are special. Because we're different. We're not caught up. We're truly out of the matrix. That's why this channel keeps getting flagged. Because this channel is freeing the mind, which reminds me that that's our thing for Soul Liberation Day. Somebody already written it up. I guess go ahead and find it. Put that up there. Our theme for Soul Liberation Day, 2024, December the 7th, 2023, is free your mind. And the rest will follow. I'm gonna take Invogue's advice. If you free your mind, the rest will follow. I thank you so much for being here. I don't feel alone. I know I'm not crazy. I know the thing that I said. I'm basing it. I already been there. I already had that mentality before. But see, the thing, what saved me really is the fact that I've always been a self-thinker. I never saw Elijah Muhammad as divine. I never did that. I just saw him as a brother trying to help us. People talking all this divine. I didn't even understand what the divine stuff was about. Every other word coming out my mouth never was Elijah Muhammad. Elijah Muhammad this, Elijah Muhammad that. I never did that. I don't even think, yes I did. I had Elijah Muhammad's picture on my wall for a little while. But again, I've never been obsessed over nobody. If I was going to do that, it'll be my mom. I was around these brothers, and they crying and screaming about Elijah Muhammad or Farrakhan like he was their girlfriend, wife or somebody. I'm looking at these brothers, All praises due to Allah for the honor of Elijah Muhammad. All praises due to Allah and clapping and
Elijah Muhammad. All praises due to Allah for Elijah Muhammad.
I'm looking, I couldn't do that. I never did that. Crying out another man's name. Now, when I went to the Invoke concert, I wanted to get Terry Ellis' attention. I was like, Terry, that's different. Now, I did that. But I ain't never screamed no man name like that. No man. I feel very funny. Furka. I can't do that. That's it feels yucky to me. Crying to another peen. I don't give a damn who you are. Holler another man's name like that. I don't know how y'all do it. And they think that's all right. They think that's all right. And then I call them out on it. They get angry. They get angry at me because I put all these women pictures, all the sisters on my page, all these women on. You put all those women. I'm male. This is beautiful to me. I love this. I love the sisters. It's beautiful to me. I like being surrounded by women. It's like a kid in a candy store. I love it. Now, I question you because you want to be around men. So, you can get angry all you want to. I'm not going to be around men like that. But December the 7th, 2023, we already know what our theme is for Soul Liberation Day. Free your mind and the rest will follow. Free your mind. That's your problem. Slave. And on that note, I really couldn't keep up with the comments. Brother Talib says, was your channel recently flagged? Yes, it was. Yes, it was. But see, the thing about it is, this channel gets the same type of views. This channel gets 10 views and the 10 subscribers. It don't make no difference. I still get the same amount of views on this channel. So it don't make any difference. And wherever I go, people gonna find me because slowly but surely, people get tired of hearing all that nonsense. They don't have to agree with me. They want to hear something different because all this stuff is getting old. It's not producing nothing. It's redundant. They keep saying the same stuff over and over again, same stuff. How many versions of the Quran Bible that's been around for 2,000 years, how many ways can you tell that damn story? We want to create our own history. I don't give a damn about those foreigners. All that stuff is foreign. Camel herder religion. Don't have nothing to do with us. Brother Talib said, and in closing, out peace. Once again, to everyone in this chat room and to number one soul, Brother Angel Stunt Number 7. Thank you, Brother Talib. Thank you to the chat room, Dickens Reality, Alma Delight, Sister Mello, everybody that support this platform. Thank you so much. Our people in London, England, Just Acting and the Resident, Sister Tangi and her crew out there in California. And of course, all our people listening around the world. And that's the wonderful thing about the internet. Whether you like it or not, we have listeners from around the world just like you do. And for every one view we get, it's worth a thousand of yours. That's guaranteed. That's fact. For every view we get, it's worth a thousand of yours, because you ain't talking about nothing. Slave ass crap. This person got angry at me. Talking about he want to debate me. That's a cool. I really don't like messing around with these flunkies, but that's a cool. I'll go ahead and do it. He blocked me. He already knew he didn't have nothing coming. You don't want to deal with, you can't deal with me in the chat room on this video on Facebook. You know damn well you're not going to be able to do nothing with me live. And I start putting some of that lawyer stuff on you. Can't do nothing with me. I fought the state of Missouri for 10 years. And won. What do you think you're going to do with me? Support Angel Snuff Nub 7. Support the Rally's Temple. If you like to, I have an autobiography in the description box. You can get a copy of that. I'm going to see if I can reduce the price on that, on the hardcover. My autobiography is on Amazon. Information is in the description box. Subscribe to the Deacons of Reality YouTube channel. Make sure you do that. We want to keep those numbers up on that channel climbing. Over 100 subscribers. Deacons of Reality channel. Also, what else is there? Anyway, that's good enough. That's good enough. If you want to, you can donate to Angel Snub Nub 7. If you want to, $ Angel Snub Nub 7. That chat, what did it call? See, I don't even remember what it was. What is Cash App? It's Cash App. See, I don't even keep up with that type of stuff. Anyway, information about our channel is in the description box of all the videos. You want to support the channel, you want to help, and you can actually call me and talk to me in person if you want to. And my email address is there. So I'm ready. I'm easily. You can contact me very, very easily. So, again, thank you so much. And I don't know when we're going to be able to talk again, but hopefully it's soon. Like I say, I got some nice things going on in my personal life pretty well. I'm happy about those things. Unfortunately, I can't talk about those things because people, we know what these folks do. Put your business out. I would advise people, don't put your personal business out on social media, because it will be used against you. And this is not a court of law. So on that note, we're going to get out of here. And as our brother, Don Cornelius, used to always say, as in parting, wish you love, peace, and soul. We are already 5,000.